Hi everybody, my name is Butternuts and welcome back to Not Your Daily Nutter. Today we are going to be talking about the real Leatherface killer known as Ed Gein, not Thomas Hewitt from the Texas Chainsaw Massacre remake. I personally myself don't know anything about the movie, but Ralph the Pistachio is here with me and he knows a little bit something, so I'm going to have him talk for a bit.
Hey, what's up guys? It's me, Ralph the Pistachio, and I'm going to talk about not the reboot or remake of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, but I'm actually going to talk to you about the 1974 Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the first ever made that's based supposedly on a true story, as you heard Butternut say, about Ed Gein. First of all, so the Texas Chainsaw Massacre 1974 is about a girl named Sally, which is played by Marilyn Burns, who hears her grandfather's grave was vandalized in Texas. So her brother and a group of friends go to Texas to check out who's been vandalizing, you know, her grandfather's grave. Once Sally arrives in Texas, she actually ends up in a gas station with a group of friends and brother and decides that she wants to explore a nearby house. The gas station owner actually hears this and decides to tell her that it's not the best idea to go wander around over other people's property, because folks down here don't take kindly to that. And let's remember, this is Texas, so they've got a thick southern accent.
And okay.
Even though I didn't do a southern accent.
We're from Texas. What are you talking about?
But we don't have a southern accent.
True. But essentially that is the plot of the movie. And something I wanted to share with you is the differences between the real life killer and the movie killer, which everything is different. First off, I'm not sure if they have the same name for both the remake and the original. The name I have here is Thomas Hewitt, and that is the name they gave to the murderer. It states here that the backstory they gave him is that just that he's born February 13th, 1969. He was born in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, whereas the real Leatherface killer, his name is Ed Gein, or Eddie Gein, born August 27th, 1906. Was born in La Crosse, Wisconsin, and died July 26, 1984 I believe that's pronounced Wappen, Wisconsin, and he died of lung cancer. And before I actually go into anything, I figured the best way to understand the killer is to really talk about the origins, I guess, the backstory, childhood, and everything, which I have right here. And if any of you guys are interested, we do have our sources in the description of the video, so you can go ahead and check it out yourself. Maybe read up on Ed Gein. I did find there is a little bit more information on there that I may not include in this podcast, but feel free to go check it out yourself. The link is in the description. But it says right here that Gein was the son of Augusta and George Gein. Augusta was a religious woman. She was his mother and constantly preached the Bible to him and his brother Henry daily. Eddie's father was an alcoholic. There's really not much to say about his father other than his mother did consider him to be completely worthless. Ed Gein's mother started a grocery business, and once she saved enough money, she moved them away to a farm in Plainfield, Wisconsin. Growing up, Ed was seen as a quiet and feminine child by others in his school, and he didn't really try making friends because every time he tried making friends, he was often scolded by his mother. So he had a lot of time to really spend alone and really explore the dark corners of his mind. Obsession isn't the word, but he worshipped his mother to no end. He would even get very upset when other people would criticize her, including his brother Henry. One day, it did not state a specific date or day, but apparently him and his brother were trying to take out a fire, and in which this around this time, Henry, Eddie's brother, was criticizing his mother. And they got in an argument. He did not like this whatsoever, so they eventually split up. They wound up going in different directions to get away from each other. Once the fire was extinguished, Eddie was starting to get a little bit worried because his brother has not returned. And so he went looking through the fields and eventually found his brother dying in the middle of the field with bruises on his head. He was not touched by the fire at all. There was bruises on his head. Once the police came by, they immediately considered Eddie as a suspect. And it said right here, yeah, Ed was immediately a suspect. And Henry's brother's death was defined as death by asphyxiation. Normally, I found a website called crimelibrary.com. The website where I got this from said that it can be found on crimelibrary.com. However, I could not get to the website at all. It seemed as if it was taken down. It's not existent anymore. We'll get to that in a bit. I found a Reddit page here, and in a bit I'll read from it in case any of you are curious about it. I actually haven't read the Reddit page, so we'll save that till the end.
Alright guys, so let me tell you a little bit more about the movie. So Leatherface in the movie The Texas Chainsaw Massacre 1974 was played by a man named Gunnar Hansen. Now if you don't know anything about Leatherface, Leatherface actually suffers from a mental disease, almost like mental retardation. And in order to capture the look and the act and the feel of Leatherface, Gunnar Hansen actually visited a special needs clinic to see how special people, if I may say, you know, walk around and act and the things that they do. He imitated people within, you know, standing from the clinic and watching them. And before you know it, he said that he could actually act like them, and people from the clinic would go up to him and try to convince him to go inside because they thought that he also needed special needs. That's how well he was able to go ahead and act and imitate these people with special needs. And for those of you who don't know or didn't know, as I just said, Leatherface is actually a victim of a mental state not so much like ourselves. A lot of people describe him as an evil character, as a killer, as a murderer, but the truth is he's more like a grown child, a child in a man's body who is usually scared and terrified because his father would abuse them in the movie as a small child. Now, when these group of individuals go ahead and explore the house, they find Leatherface, but the truth is if you pay attention, Leatherface isn't trying to be evil, he isn't trying to murder these kids, but he's just so scared that he needs to defend himself, almost like an animal. Not that he is one, but he is very scared and he tries to defend himself. Usually people say that the weapons that he used are a little too grotesque. How would he know how to use a chainsaw? Chances are it's probably because of the environment that he grew up in. He grew up in this shack out of nowhere. His dad let him just play with whatever he wants. I think the mallet, sledgehammer, whatever you want to call it, the chainsaw and the meat hook, which are weapons that he used, are actually just products of his environment. He just saw them as toys, just a normal kid could pick up a rock and give it a reason behind.
Actually, believe it or not, I'm glad you mentioned the weapons and the chainsaw, because it turns out actually both the original and the remake are only lightly based on the true story in which the murder of most of his victims took place around 1954 to 1957. The one thing they did get most accurate was the portrayal of Ed Gein's home and the just grotesque gore and disgusting things that they found there.
Unsanitary.
Yes. Here are some similarities as to the real Ed Gein and the Leatherface killer in the movie. Despite whichever one you go to, either way, each one is only lightly based on Ed Gein. What I got was, the real Ed Gein did wear human scalp and face, but it was not the only reason for this was to help quell his desire to be a woman.
Actually, if you don't mind saying this, the Leatherface character actually has a outfit that's named the Pretty Woman, where he actually wears a mask of skin, where he actually puts makeup on it. It looks white with rosy cheeks, and for some reason he tends to use a suit with it instead of a dress. But that's what the costume is called, and it's very womanesque when it comes to the facial features.
And as well, not just the wearing the face, but he also wore a vest made of skin, and that vest came with breast and female genitalia that he strapped above his own.
Whoa.
So, really? Yes, he had breast and female genitalia above his own on this vest.
Was it a real vest? Like, as in skin, or?
I believe it was made of skin, yes.
Oh, Jesus Christ. For those of you who don't know, the Leatherface in the movie is called Leatherface for a reason. Usually what he does is whenever he finds someone who he thinks is a threat, he attacks them, and he usually takes off the face of his victim and puts it above himself, hence the name Leatherface. He tries to make it a mask, but usually he does this to a lot, him and his family. It's not only him that lives in that, you know, weird cabin, tend to just hunt animals. Their furniture is made out of bone and out of bone and skin from different types of animals. So they tend to skin and make decorative pieces of bones and meat and skin from animals. So to him, a human being is almost like another animal, and he tends to skin it and make a different types of masks from it.
Oh, actually, speaking of the skinning, you know, believe it or not, it actually wasn't believed that he used a chainsaw.
Really?
Yeah, it actually, I mean, maybe he might have used one at some point, I'm not sure, but really, it wasn't believed that he used a chainsaw. In fact, Ed Gein's identified victims, the people actually identified, Mary Hogan and Bernice Warden, which, by the way, I want to bring up, both women, hence how he could have made the vest and wear their faces, being that he had such a desire to be a woman. But, you know, they're both women. Mary Hogan and Bernice Warden were shot with a pistol in November of 1957.
That's a big change.
Yeah.
Pistol and a chainsaw?
Yeah, because, and honestly, I mean, for somebody collecting faces and vest of skin, I highly doubt he used a chainsaw.
Absolutely, but I'm pretty sure they had a good reason to use a chainsaw. They just used it to promote the film.
Yeah, obviously it was just for the film, just add a little extra gore. I mean, the gore was still there. It says right here that in his home, Bernice's body was found with her head removed. She was decapitated and she was gutted like a deer.
Damn. Well, that actually.
I'm sorry, but just your.
Damn.
I'm sorry, but that was so funny. Just your random. There was no emotion to that. It was just damn.
Straight face.
Damn. You were so shocked.
It was just straight face. Damn.
You were so shocked. You were just like, damn.
But that actually goes back to the movie, how they skin and gut different animals. Maybe Ed Gein did that himself.
I'm sorry, I've never heard such a genuine damn in my life.
Wow, you fucking green-headed motherfucker. You look more like a pistachio than I do. With that green hair.
Oh, it's funny. Haven't you ever seen how peanuts sometimes have the little green on their heads or some shit?
No, I haven't seen it. Well, anyway, first of all, let me clear this out. Butternut's laugh is real. You think it's fake, you think he's faking it, and you think he's a poser and some type of bitch, but his laugh is real, okay? You can't deny it. His laugh is actually real. That's how he laughs, ladies and gentlemen. It sucks to be him.
Oh, I bit my lip.
This is for all, if any of you had spaghetti with one large meatball in the middle for dinner, hurrah. And if any of you had mozzarella cheese pizza with olives, hurrah to you as well.
Oh man. Yeah, that's what we had for lunch.
That's all we had.
Dude, it's like 5. It's like not even 6. I don't even think that was lunch.
Yeah, that was.
I'm actually getting kind of hungry in a bit. We'll have to get something.
Yeah.
Alright, where was I? Oh god, you made me lose my fucking mind with your damn. That's a huge difference, just going from
Did you see that?
I saw this. But he was talking about the spikes. We're actually looking at the waveforms on Audacity. But if you think about it, that's actually a huge difference between a gun and a chainsaw. See, here's the thing. I understand changing it for the sake of making it an entertaining movie, but that is just such a huge difference. I mean, there have been killers in movies that use guns, right?
Yeah.
I believe so.
But, I mean, if you think about it, a killer who uses a gun is not even nearly as exciting as someone who uses a fucking chainsaw. Come on, it's a chainsaw. The sound it makes. You ever played Resident Evil 4? When those motherfuckers with chainsaws come out and you run for your life and they still cut your head off? That's not a chainsaw. That's butternuts.
Yeah. Actually, a fun little fun fact about Resident Evil 4. Well, not about Resident Evil 4, but me playing Resident Evil 4. You know how it has that mercenaries mode?
Uh-huh. When you look up her skirt and she's like, no!
What the fuck was that? But you know how it has that mercenaries mode?
Yeah.
Actually, but right now, one of the times I was playing it, mm-hmm. I was getting surrounded, and then the mission was about to end in like 5 seconds, and one of the like chainsaw sisters literally runs up to me and hits my neck, and the chainsaw cuts through half of my character's neck, which I think I was playing as Honk at the time. Mm-hmm. But because his health didn't go all the way down in time, I actually finished that level and with like 4 stars, I think.
So you survived the chainsaw attack in Resident Evil 4?
Yes. Completely on accident. Because his health didn't go all the way down by the time that the timer ended. And it was the fucking best.
Wow. Okay, so this part of the segment is our advertisements. We only have one today. And this is it. This video is brought to you by Mortal Kombat X. Those of you who didn't know, Leatherface is coming out in Mortal Kombat X, and Mortal Kombat X is paying us to do this, which they are not, but they should really pay us because Mortal Kombat X is super cool and we need money and we really need to go eat and we need money. We only had one lunch, come on. And Leatherface, we're talking about Leatherface, and Leatherface coming out in Mortal Kombat X, so you should definitely pay us.
He's already out. He's already out. Anything else?
This video is also brought to you by Fiji Water.
I was talking about the movie.
Okay.
Sorry, we're spastic today. I'm actually a little hungry again.
Me too.
Sorry, I had to edit that out.
Okay, anyway, well, let's talk about some more fun things instead of such serious, grotesque brutality. That nasty Ed Gein, filthy bastard.
By the way, really quick, I just want to apologize if you kind of hear us go in and out a lot. My microphone, I probably should have said this in the beginning, but my microphone is a little, I'm still working out the kinks.
So. They jacked his old microphone. They jacked it.
Yeah, I'm still working out the kinks.
Some cholo jacked his microphone. Some ruthless cholo.
So I got this new one and...
They jacked it.
Me and Ralph keep having to get closer to the microphone.
Pistachio.
Me and Ralph the pistachio keep having to get
close. I'm actually getting way too close.
Yeah, you're getting really
close. I've been getting way too close.
You have been getting this close the entire time.
And I haven't even noticed. Look at that.
And I wanted to say something.
You should have said
something. But as long as I'm getting good audio.
As long
as
the struggle is real.
As long as they can hear you, I'm going to have to do so much editing.
You're going to... you think you can deal with that?
Yeah, I can deal with that.
Okay, well, anyway... well, in a more fun-esque manner, let's talk about... the weapons that Sir Leatherface used. Yeah. So one of the weapons that he used, of course, is a chainsaw. You all know he rips people in half. He rips people from side to side, tears their flesh, which does bring to question how the hell does he use their skin if he tears it up? But that's one of his weapons. The other is like a mini sledgehammer mallet type of thing. I know. And... his last weapon is actually a meat hook. He literally will grab people and impale them in a meat hook and beat them to death. Those are some pretty crazy weapons that I would have never thought about. A meat hook? A meat hook. Literally, who would have thought of that? Sledgehammer, mallet, okay. Chainsaw, totally awesome, but honestly, I wouldn't have thought of that. Maybe I'm just not imaginatory, if that's even a word enough.
creative,
you mean? Creative enough, yeah.
I guess.
But you know what? Let's go ahead and make assumptions. What would be the craziest weapons a serial killer could use? But not only the craziest, but the creepiest. How would he use them?
You know what would be cool?
What?
I always imagined a really cool serial killer poisoning all his victims. Like not even killing them, just finding a way to poison them, either by befriending them, somehow even going to a complete stranger and somehow spiking their drink in public without even being spotted.
Bill Cosby?
Did he really do that? Did he really do that?
No, I was just wondering, like, are you talking about, I mean, the poor dang?
Did he really do that?
Yes!
Is that what the case is about?
98 women, like, maybe I'm exaggerating, but like, 50-something women have came up and said that they have been violated by Bill Cosby.
I didn't know. I mean, I knew he was a violator.
That serial killer you're thinking about? Yeah, he's real. Well, maybe not the poisoning, but he does roof them. I'm sorry, Bill. But if it's true, you belong in jail.
Okay, so
edit that out. Edit that out, please. Do not put that.
Okay, so somebody make a horror movie about Bill Cosby.
He's pretty scary.
Not gonna lie. Okay, would you like some poison pudding? Okay. I can't. That was a terrible impression.
You mind if I put in this dick in your mouth?
You like pudding? How about you try putting this dick in your mouth? Oh god, we're so stupid. But
okay, let's think about more weapons. How about a crucifix?
A crucifix.
We were talking about The Exorcist the other day and what she does with one of those. If you haven't seen that video, yeah, link in description. We talked about The Exorcist and all these horror films that talk about this nasty, grotesque, and inhumane stuff. Watch it. It's crazy. But a crucifix?
The other day. That video was 4 months ago.
Shut the fuck up, butternuts. But imagine if somebody would kill people with a crucifix or kill them and then put them in a crucifix. I'm pretty sure maybe that has been done in a movie before, but it would be pretty creepy as fuck, especially if you're black or religious.
What? What? I mean, I'm pretty sure if we were to look around, there's somebody who's done that. There was, what was that guy's name? I was about to say Ted Cruz.
Ted Cruz?
I was about to say Ted Cruz.
What the fuck?
I don't actually mean Ted Cruz. What was his name? Ted Bundy. There we go.
Ted Bundy, I did a report on him.
Yeah, and I don't know why Ted Cruz. Ted Bundy, Ted Cruz.
Same thing.
One's Canadian, one's a murderer. I mean, come on.
They're both murdering something.
I'm sorry, that was funny. Oh, man.
But what were you saying? Ted Bundy what?
I like Ted Bundy. Oh, Ted Bundy didn't really use a weapon,
dude. He used his charm. How many times have you heard that? He literally would go to beaches and pretend that he had a broken arm or ankle, and he would lure women to help him into his car, and then he would murder them. He's a necrophilian, if that's even a word.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the thing with most killers, too, is that they have a certain...
Obsession?
Obsession and a pattern of doing things. For example, Ed Gein and his,
Removal of the skin?
Yeah, I was gonna say chainsaw, but, you know, that's directly towards the movie.
Yeah.
Who knows? He might have even used one just for the hell of it. But, I mean, really, those are the only two examples I use because those are his two identified victims.
Yeah.
He was involved in a lot of missing persons cases. Or at least he was a suspect of them. You know, of all things, I never looked up if you went to jail or anything. Of all things, lung cancer got him?
You would think that's something else. Maybe, I don't know. Was he a smoker?
I don't think so. I didn't find anything saying that he would be a smoker, even if it was influenced by his father, because his father was an alcoholic. He could have been a smoker, but who knows?
Who knows? Can you think of any more weapons?
Pretty sure there's someone out there who's used, like, hammer.
No. I'm talking about bizarre. You have to be bizarre. Like, think something that you wouldn't even think about. Like, what's at work and you look at it and you're like, man, that can kill someone, but nobody else would think about it.
I mean, I don't know. I work with knives and stuff. I guess spatulas.
No. Something less I mean, a crucifix is pretty cool because you would never expect that.
Yeah, you would never. That is the very definition of a bizarre.
You can walk into a place with a crucifix and they wouldn't stop you, and you can murder someone with it. Don't do it.
Don't do that. I mean,
that's fucked up.
I guess you're just still thinking about The Exorcist. That did traumatize you, didn't it?
Maybe.
Yeah, that scene traumatized you. But
I was 5, okay? Just kidding, I wasn't 5. I don't know how old.
I don't know, maybe a back scratcher.
A back scratcher?
They like sharpen.
Would you scratch someone's balls to death? What would you do with that?
I mean, you can sharpen the edges. You can put like tiny little blades on them. You can put tiny little blades on that. Stop scratching yourself, Ralph.
That's killing me, man.
Yeah, but you could put like tiny little. You said bizarre.
You know what? I'll give you creative points.
Yeah, you could. You can
like without modifying.
Without modifying. Okay.
No. Well, yeah. Well, that's so. It's almost like if I say I get a piece of wood and I put a knife in it, or I tape a knife to it.
I mean, you mean like those like the bats with nails in them and shit?
Yeah, not that.
I mean, true, but that would be an interesting. Can you imagine if there was a killer who would use that bat, just go around, just the news, the headlines that would come out, like,
oh Jesus Christ, that yeah. would scare the crap out of me.
I would lose my shit.
For example, another weapon that's really creative, if you've seen No Country for Old Men, the main protagonist actually carries an air canister that actually releases air at a very high pressure, and he uses this not only to kill people by putting the air pressure to their head and releasing it, but he can actually unlock doors with that high of a pressure by putting it in the doorknob and releasing it.
Then again, is it really always a weapon? Because, like I said, everyone has their own patterns. There was Jack the Ripper who would...
Which we talked about in the other podcast we used to watch.
Which he would like rip apart his victims, cut them to pieces and stuff. There was... I'm trying to think of more serial killers. I don't know why I'm drawing a blank. I thought of Ted Bundy. I said Ted Bundy already, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I said Ted Bundy already. But I don't know. Actually, something I found interesting, too. Before we move on, anything else? Weapon-related? Any serial killers? Preferably similar to Ed Gein?
What weapon would you be scared to die to?
Yeah, go ahead. We'd like to... I think for me, something sharp. Definitely something sharp. A knife. I'm sorry, but to me, I think being stabbed is like the worst thing in the world. It's so scary. Sure, you could be shot. You could be torn apart by a chainsaw, but that's going to be faster than a fucking knife. Not to mention if they stab you in the stomach, you get stomach acids everywhere. It's just,
Yeah, stomach acids are a horrible thing. But I think chainsaw wins... with not the pain that it inflicts, but the noise and sound it would make. If someone chases you down with that, that'd be pretty creepy.
True, that would be very scary. Alright, and moving on. Believe it or not, there are actually 2 more movies based on Ed Gein.
Which I didn't know.
Actually, let's see if you can guess at least one of them.
Ed Gein.
Yes, based on Ed Gein.
That's the movie, Ed Gein.
Nope.
Give me some hints.
They are fictional. No, actually, I don't even want to say that because I haven't seen either of these two, so I probably shouldn't say that.
Okay.
Hit me. I'll give you a hint. Okay. One of them, the similarities they share with Ed Gein, one of them is their feminine qualities, whereas the other one, one of them... also shares the desire to be a woman.
The desire to be a woman.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus. Desire to be a woman. I'm trying to think of a movie. I have no idea.
It's the first one is Psycho.
Psycho?
Psycho. It says right here, of course, the killer, Anthony Perkins. The similarities between Psycho and... well, Anthony Perkins and Ed Gein are their feminine qualities, and both of them have strong attachments to their domineering mothers.
Wow.
Also, Silence of the Lambs.
Silence of the Lambs.
Yes. Silence of the Lambs. The similarities between Buffalo Bill and Ed Gein are the desire to be a woman, Both of them skinned their victims. Both of them liked to wear flesh, but Buffalo Bill chose younger victims than Ed Gein.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
So Ed Gein's victims were... I don't think I found a specific age group, but significantly older than those of the victims of Buffalo Bill.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, I told you this was disgusting. Oh, man. I gotta tell you, I'm honestly really surprised about this. I really am. The other thing, one thing I want to talk about, though, is the crime library.
The crime library.
Yeah, so I guess it was for, I'm not sure if it was for all possible, like, documented cases, but the source that I cited down in the description has a particular part, specifically the part where I talk about Henry, Eddie's brother, and it gave me the link, crimelibrary.com, but if you were to go to crimelibrary.com, it's actually not there. Actually, let me start recording the monitor so I can actually show you guys, and I can show you guys the Reddit page. This will take a second. Just give me one quick moment. Okay, I'm sorry about that. But for those of you that were curious, here's the page real quick giving information that I found. A lot of it was from this site. It does give other information and links. So I highly recommend you guys check it out. This is the part that I was talking about. This part right here that says crimelibrary.com. But if I were to go to crimelibrary.com, give me a moment. Did I spell it right? But if I try going to crimelibrary.com, it says this webpage is not available. And I've tried multiple ways of trying to get on it, and then I ran into this Reddit page. Okay. So after spending, I'm sorry, let me highlight it. So after spending hours searching for the crime library and questioning my sanity if the website was in fact called that or not, I found a post here about the site being shut down. Does anyone know why it happened? I loved reading it and had thought of some cases I wanted to look up, which led me here. Anyone know? And this was 10 months ago by Nightmare Dress Dream. Now, Reddit user Stacy Hates Macy's 10 months ago says... I'd rather not highlight this. Let me just read it off. Okay, guys. I was managing the editor...
That doesn't sound like Stacy.
Shut up.
That doesn't sound like Stacy.
Stacy's mom has got it going on. I'm kidding.
That does not sound like Stacy.
I'm not going to sound like Stacy.
You have to sound like
Stacy. My voice can't go that high.
Are you scared?
Okay, guys. I was managing the editor... Shut up, all
right? No.
Okay, guys, I was managing the editor of Crime Library for 3 years up until close to the time that it was shut down. I'm sorry that I didn't make some kind of announcement that it was going to happen. Basically, I don't use Reddit, so I have no idea what that means. UMD Castle is right, as its brand strategy veered farther and farther away from true crime. True TV continuously reduced support and funding for Crime Library. Also, over time, the main advocates of Crime Library, who are mostly court TV holdovers and into the crime stuff, were either laid off or quit. There has been a lot of turnover at True TV over the years, and as new people took power, Crime Library was far from their highest priority. This site didn't jive with the network's brand strategy, and even after all the True TV branding was removed from it, they were still uncomfortable with having this gore fest of a website under their brand umbrella. Additionally, the website went through a lot of redesigns, half-baked republishing efforts, and changed hands a number of times, which meant that structurally, it was an absolute mess. Literally two people in the world, myself and one other person, knew how to navigate the hoarder's attic of a website. There was no one at the network who wanted to touch it. There was no one at the network who wanted to touch it in case of a threat or lawsuit, which happens fairly often when you're posting mugshots and arrest stories. Nobody would even know where to find the offending content. On a more editorial note, Crime Library really began to suffer during the rise of clickbait. HuffPo, BuzzFeed, etc. Oh, fucking BuzzFeed, man. Etc. We felt pressured to spend more time and resources on one-off funny arrest and zippy news bites with links to other sites rather than long, well-researched content. All that said, it was a great ride, and although we never had the audience of the bigger, prettier websites, we had a dedicated audience of crime buffs or murder nerds, as I have been called. And as everything on the internet, Crime Library lives on in spirit. All the content can be found on the Wayback Machine.
Who wrote that?
That was Stacy Hates Macy's 10 months ago. Let's actually check it out.
So what is that?
Basically, oh, wow. Oh, okay. Okay, this is an archive. Basically, I'm going to try and explain it the best I can. Basically, so you can go back and see what websites used to look like. The best example I could think of is PewDiePie made a video where he archived YouTube to see the different layouts of YouTube and see how the channel has changed and how YouTube has changed. But that's essentially what it is. That's essentially what it is you get to go back and see how the website was. So I'm not sure if there's any specific way to find anything on Ed Gein, though. Snapshot. Nope. Nothing. Oh! Oh! Somebody confessed to a murder online and indicated a location of the body. Okay.
That's just news.
Yeah, is it? No, I think this is from this. Yeah, see, Crime Library, Criminal Minds and Methods. Let's see if we can find anything on. Oh, we can't search. Oh, yes, we can.
I thought Crime Library was gone.
Yeah, but the archive lets me go to
what it used to be.
Yeah. But yeah, the archive lets me go back to, I guess, previous forms of the internet,
okay,
of the website or whatever. Wayback Machine doesn't have that page archived. Strange. Might as well stop recording. Thank you guys so much for listening to the podcast. You have no idea how much it means to us.
Thank you.
Especially if you were to stay for the whole time.
Gracias.
Maybe you can listen to it at work while you're doing stuff, but the reason why we wanted to do this podcast based off the Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie is because we want to see how the movie holds up, and a lot of the reviews you'll find, you can probably find a few good ones, but we want to see how the movie holds up and just how good it is today with how movies have evolved and just everything.
I think it's going to be a masterpiece.
Yeah, so we're gonna watch the original, not the 2003 remake. We're gonna be watching the original, see how that one held up. Maybe we'll do a remake, but I'm not completely sure. But if you guys are interested, please subscribe so you don't miss when that video comes out.
And also look forward to more classic horror films reviews.
Yes, we'll be doing more classic horror film reviews, as well as we'll be doing a few new movies that come out, regardless of whether they're horror movies or not.
And also important new gaming content.
Exactly. By the way, don't pay attention to the videos on the I know I haven't uploaded in like a month, but I've been having issues with getting a microphone. It's been a pain in the ass, but please, I highly recommend that you guys subscribe if you are into that kind of content. Anything having to do with classic horror movies, video games, anything, we'll deliver it for you.
Yes, thank you so much for listening to us jabber on and off about the movie.
And I know we're stupid fucking idiots, but
we're cool fucking idiots.
Yeah, and We like to talk about stuff and...
and that sums it up. We like to talk about stuff.
Well, we like to talk about stuff. Thank you guys again so much for listening to the podcast. Subscribe if you don't want to miss any content like this or anything you might have heard that you are interested in. And I will see you guys next time. Butternuts out.
Bye.
Did you lick my microphone earlier? No. Okay.